I once again all of you welcome to the lecture series of electric power ecology. Okay, so now we are successfully completed the four chapters in this power ecology. So first unit we are seeing that what are the basic power quality issues, what are the different types of power qualities and all of this. First two units, the terms we are already learned. So third unit we are discussing about the some old water voltage sags, in depth voltage sags, wells, so on interruption, all other things. Then fourth unit we are completed the some voltage regulations, how to minimize these voltage regulations and all other things. Okay, now we are comes under the fifth chapter. That fifth chapter is distributed generation and power quality. It's nothing but DGs. We are already used these DGs to improve the voltage regulations, nothing but to improve the power quality. So these distributed generators, generation units are used to improve the power quality. So power quality issues. So mainly for regulating the voltage regulation, is nothing but to maintain the constant voltage levels at the load sites, to maintain the uninterrupted power supply at the load sites. So that's why we are considering this distributed generation DGs. So now in this unit 5, so we are going to discuss what are the different types of DGs, what are the different technologies that employed in the DGs, then how these distributed generators will help to improve the power quality, then how these DGs will be interconnected. Then what are the problems while interconnected these DGs to the grid? So what type of problems we are going to face? So how to minimize that problems? So by using these DGs, how to improve the power quality? All the things we are going to discuss in this unit 5. Okay, distributed generation. You know that distributed generation. What is this distributed generation? So simply, it is like a small generating units that may be of diesel generator sets, of that may be of a small power plants, is like gas plants, or that may be of small water plants, nothing but hydro plants, that may be of gas plants, that may be of renewable energies, is nothing but the tidal energy, or nothing but ocean energy, or it may be of so fossil fuels energy, water it may be. But these are very small generating units near to the load locations. Remember, these are very small generating units, but are near to the load locations. Okay, so now see this different types of DGs and all. So now see this DGs are very small in size. Okay. So these are very small in size. It's nothing but the in megawatts. These are DGs will be considered in the less than 10 megawatts of series. So these DGs are closer to the load. So remember all these points. Remember all these points very carefully. Each and every word in the PPT is important. Okay. So now see this. So DG will be nothing but a distributed generation. I said DG not nothing but the it is not the diesel generators. DG is nothing but the distributed generators or distributed generation. Okay, distributed generation is the correct word for the DG. So these are very small in size. DGs, you just say small size generators. Nothing but those are very much near to the load locations. So that DG's plant size is less than 10 megawatts. So now see this in normal distribution. You see this normal distribution. So nothing but you can generate the power in one site. It's nothing but one place. You can transmit that power by using the transmission lines. You can distribute that power by using the distributed lines. And again, we can again you can give in that. Supply to the some utility lines to the consumers. So there are because of this wires, nothing but hundreds of kilometers of these wires, will gives this some power quality issues, will raises some power quality issues. But remember, whenever this DCs are near to the loads, we are not using the transmission as well as distribution lines. We are simply connecting the some lines or some wires to these load locations, and then we can supply that power by using that DCs. But why these DCs are not much effective when compared to this normal distribution system or normal transmission systems or all other things we are going to discuss? Okay, there are several power quality issues when we are using transmission and distribution the power by using the wires. You are getting so many transmission issues. You know that what are the some power quality issues. You know that some tree branches falling on that one, then the distance is increases, then the factors in that voltages and currents are changes, some impedance in that lines are changes. So many factors will affect. So by using this DC, you are also improve the power quality. So we already seen this DCs in fourth chapter, to regulate the voltage regulation, to improve the voltage regulation by using this DC. Simply, DCs will supply the some amount of voltages to the system. Whenever the system nothing but the power plant may shut down, or the our transmission lines may open, our distribution lines may open, at that time this DC will supply the voltage to the loads. So that one, we can maintain the continuity of the power supply. That is also on power quality problem. So when you maintain the continuity of the power, or when you give the continuity of the power, that is also power quality. Okay, that is also comes under the power quality. Okay, so when this DCs are closer to the loads to the locations, because of this reason, so the losses, the transmission as well as distribution losses, we are going to be used. Okay, but why this DCs are not very much power? Because why this? Because the availability of the place, the availability of the resources. Okay, the main issue is economical reasons. The land, the water, then the transportations. At the same time, the cost of the devices, the cost of the lands, some water problems as well as the all other things. So the maintenance problems, all other things will reduces the uses of these things. So now see this, but nowadays, DCs are very much powerful. Nowadays, DCs is nothing but we can see anywhere in our households also we are using the DCs, nothing but a solar plates. In our college, we have two distributed generation plants. You know that in our college, a solar plant. So two plants are there. So one is 250 kilowatt is present at the one place, and again 140 kilowatt is present at the another place in our college also. So the entire CRT institution, it has very big number to maintain that solar power. So that is also on distribution generation. That is very much near to the load. So in our college, it has the load. So where the DC is present, so it is under college only itself, but it is under load location only. So that is the usage of the load. So there is no need for transmission or no need for distribution for this DC's power. So that is the main advantage. What is the then? But in some days, nothing but in 2000 century, so DC's are using very less because of the some reasons. But nowadays, the DC's resurgence is nothing but the newborn. It's nothing but a new thing, newly born. So newly opportunities in the DCs are increased because of the technology. Due to power, power issue. Okay, now see this, the technology that is changing. So very advanced technology we are using nowadays. So that's why, okay, That's why this is very much essential for that. Okay. Now see this this one. Next one. Okay, full screen. I'm exiting this one. So the internet is very slow. Okay. Now see this resurgence. So regenerating this problem. Regeneration, nothing but how to deploy this or how to regenerate this disease in the nowadays world because of the technologies, nowadays technology. So this disease usage is very much essential, and so in our India is also trying to push 100 gigawatts of disease in next 5 to 10 years. So renewable energies. So this is mainly utilizes the renewable energies. Okay, so natural resources. So for the last 10 years, for the last 10 decades, so now see this DGs uses this DGs. So last 10 decades we are using the very old technique, like so we are generate the power at one place, one station or one place. So we can transmit by using the transmission lines. Then again, by using some distribution system, you can distribute the lines. By using this utility, you can some consumers, you can give them some consumers. Okay, this 10 is continue up to the date. Okay, so by using these lines, some you know that why this 10 is followed, nothing but you are generating the power at one place and we are transmitting that another place, nothing but because of the resources available. So for generating stations, you require the large amount of area. Then water, you require the water, some dump pads, some other factors are there. So that's why we are generating the power at one case or one place. Then by using this transmission and distribution lines, we are giving to the consumers. You know that we are already visited the VTPS in our area. So that VTPS power is connected to the central grid. So and given it to the some entire the nation. So according to that power. So now India is moving towards the one grid, one nation scheme. So the entire generating stations in our India is connected to that grid. Okay. So according to the state usages and purchase options and other things, so the central government is dividing the power based on the uses. So many reasons are there you have to place the generating station very far away from the load locations. So availability of the, so the first thing is economical reasons. So everything is depends upon the money, economical reasons, nothing but the cost of the land, cost of the water supply, so cost of the transmission lines, cost of the distribution lines, the how many kilometers you are going to transmit the lines. You know that some hydel plants, so that dams are located very far away from the node locations. So by laying the transmission distribution lines are very much a difficulty to transmit the power or distribute the power, even though we are placing generating station at some very far away from the stations because of the availability of the sources. Okay, resources, availability of the resources. So now this DGs, distributed generators, at some nearly 19th century at that time, they are introduced, but that are not much usage in the power systems. But nowadays technology is allowing to use this. Our government is also encouraging the uses of this distributed generators. distribution generations. This is nothing but solar plants, small solar plants, then wind plants, then tidal plants, some all other things we are nowadays we are using the renewable energy sources. So this so now see this so this new technologies. Sorry, I don't know that some technical problem in this Zoom. Okay, now see this. So this new technologies will allow this DGs to add this DGs also to the grid. And new technologies are there. So the best example in our college where we have the 250 kilowatt and 150 kilowatt solar plants are there. By using the one concept called net metering, you know that what is a net metering. So by using that technique, so the some amount of power we are giving it to the some grid whenever we are not using the college. Okay, so in the evening time and morning time our college is not functioning, so on the time the generated energy by using the solar cells were given it to the grid. So on the running time is nothing but 9 to 5 on the time the college will be open, and then some large size motors and all other things, slabs are operated. So on the time the power we are going to take it from the grid. So what it may be, so by using the new technologies, so it is very much easier to install the this DGs near to the load locations. So these DGs is able to possible this DGs to integrate into the grid cells. So this we can call it as a micro grid, a very small. So this technology is very much advanced to it will allow these DGs to integrate into the grid cells. Remember, DGs concept is nothing but whenever these DGs are located near to the load locations, that you can call it as a DG, a distributed generation. Or someone they can also call it as an embedded generation also, whatever. So if these DGs are able to connect the grid, that you can call it as the micro, is nothing but micro means a very small, nothing but this, when compared to the grid size, the megawatt or gigawatt of the grid size, this DG size is very small. So that's why we can call it as a micro grids. So the technology is changing nowadays. So that's why we are able to connect this DGs to the grids also. The best example in our college. So we have, there are some perspectives on DG benefits. What are the some perspectives? Some end user. So we have some 3 points here we are going to discuss here. An end user perspective. So what is the perspective? What an end user is going to think that DGs? What is the benefits of these DGs? So what is the main benefit of these DGs? You have to maintain the continuity of the supply. Whenever there is, you know that in a few years back, 2015 on that time, so nearly three states, Odisha and Bihar and all other things, and because of the failure of the grid, so the states are under power cut nearly 2 to 3 days. Okay, that is also happened. So for suppose you take in our industry, small industry like our some industry our college also can take. You know, there is some problem in the distribution lines. There is some breakdown of the some installations. The power cut is happening. So without power, the college functioning is very difficulty task nowadays. Or without power, in any industry is difficulty task. What will happen? So on that time, we are going to on the generators, a diesel generating station. That is also on distributed generation, diesel. So we have to maintain uninterrupted power because of using these DGs. Or we have some laboratories also. In the laboratories, we are using some fuel system batteries to maintain uninterrupted power supply. Especially in all in exams time, on that time, so power cut is happened. but your exam is not interrupted. So that purpose, what they are using here, a fuel system, that means batteries to maintain uninterrupted power supply. So that is also on DC. So benefit of the DC, so it has to maintain the some nothing but the uninterrupted power supply. So that's why it improves the reliability of this. Okay, so this is the end user perspective. So I am the user. I am thinking that if I have the DC, that but in our household also we are using some battery cells. Why you are using the batteries in our household? Nothing but inverters in our household to maintain the uninterrupted power supply. Now there is a power cut, so there's that the battery will supply the energy to in our households to maintain uninterrupted power supply. So to maintain, you are not facing power cuts in our houses. So that is our end user is thinking like that. Is this DC concept? So what the distribution companies is thinking DCs? What distribution companies perspective? What they are thinking by installing this DCs near to the load locations? What they are thinking? So they are thinking very much positively because of this DCs installed near to the load locations. The losses of the transmission and distribution lines is very much lesser, so you can greatly reduces the burden of the transmission and distribution lines also. So you can reduces the burden, or you can reduces the losses that is faced by the transmission as well as the distribution systems. So this is the distribution company's perspective. That the distribution companies means here transmission distribution agencies. Those perspective is that. So we have to reduce the losses. We have to reduce the transmission losses as nothing but transmission cost as well as the distribution cost. And at the same time, we have to give in some relief to that burden of the over nothing but over capacity of the loads. So we have to give in some relief. Nothing but so DCs we are placed near the load centers. So the utility of the transmission as well as distribution lines is reduces. The load on that lines is reduces. So on that way they are thinking that this one. So what is the commercial aspective point of view? Commercially, how this DCs will help to improve the nothing but economically as commercial is nothing but how this DCs will improve the power quality issues. Okay, how this DCs will helpful to reduce this power quality issues. So by using this DCs, how to reduces the power bill. So in our college we are using this distributed generation is nothing but solar plants. Greatly we are reducing the cost of the every month. Nothing but in our college nearly 4 lakhs to 5 lakhs bill is there for monthly power bill. So because of this solar plants, we are reducing that to the 1 to 2 lakh. So that much you are reducing the power because of the net metering concept. So but commercial way, how much it is helpful. But initially, this DCs installation is somewhat costly. But in the days going on, so the cost is nothing but it will get the money from the selling the power to the distribution or agencies. So this is the perspective of DC benefits. Then there are small disadvantages of this DC also. How the people is thinking about the DCs? Then what about the maintenance and cost? What about the maintenance? The main concern is about the end user is thinking about that one. What is the maintenance cost? So suppose in our farmers also using the this DCs for motors and all other things, some borewells and other things. So nowadays in our India, so 1 kilowatt is equivalent to the 1 lakh cost. So installing the solar plants, so 1 kilowatt power or 1 kilowatt plant you are going to install, that will cost up to the 1 lakh. If the range is increases, that cost is reducing. So the kilowatt range is increasing, so the cost somewhat is decreasing. So at presently, so for 1 kilowatt nearly it has 1 lakh cost is there to install the solar plants. So So then end user is think that some what about the maintenance and all other tasks. So then at the same time end user really want to operate this centers. So will electricity actually cost less than the more reliable? You know that. So in 2005 or 2006 on that time, the cost of this renewable energy, nothing but this solar energy or nothing but wind energy, will nearly 15 rupees on that time at early days. Now that price is reduces to the 3 rupees below 3 rupees, 2.45 also, 2.5, 2.7. Because of newer technologies has comes under the picture. So the cost of that solar plates and all other things will reduces. So that's why every household, so most of the households and apartments are also going to install this solar plants. So we'll think that whenever we are going to install the DGs in our load locations or in our houses, is it really helpful to reduce our electricity bill or else? So will power market continue to favorable towards DG? So whenever you are going to install, so for suppose you are installing this solar plant in our house, a small solar. So when you gain the money by using this solar, so it will take up to the nearly 15 years time to get that money, 10 to 15 years time. So on that time, you will be able to continue this benefits to the government. Government is continuing the benefits. So whenever this disease is increasing day by day, so is that disease is feasible to solve the problems or not? All of these are some disadvantages while you are considering this introduction of the disease in the system. So what are the some perspectives on interconnection? So what are these some interconnection perspectives? So where you can interconnected this DGs? So as I said, DGs most preferably is installed near to the load locations. Okay, these are the two cases, this case one and case two we are assuming here. These are the two cases while these DGs are installed. Now see this first case, that 9.1, end user and generator on owner perspective of the interconnection agreement. So at the load center, we are installing this DG at the load center, like our college. We are installing this DG. So now this is another case 9.2 diagram 9.2. This is another case. So we are installing these DGs near to the load location, but the same bus, the same feeder. We are installing the somewhere, but the same feeder. We are installing these DGs in somewhere, but near to the load location, but in somewhere, but installing the same feeder. Likewise, like some interconnection. Interconnection is there. Okay, so how this DGs, whenever you are interconnecting these DGs, how these DGs will help to improve the power quality? Okay, this DGs will definitely help to improve the power quality issues, definitely, because this will maintain the voltage levels and constant voltage levels, and at the same time whenever their load is suddenly increases, on that time when the DG is available, you can on the DG. So that increased load will maintained by these DGs. I will supply the power through these DGs. That's where you will reduce the burden of the transmission as well as the distribution line also, as well as generating stations. But now see this DG is very small when compared to the grid. You know that our grid is nearly in our India 320 gigawatt and more, above 320 gigawatt power we are generating every day in our India. But this DG is less than 10 megawatt, you remember. So you can compare that gigawatt to the this megawatt, less than 10 megawatt power. So when compared to this grid, this DG is very small. Okay, So, because of this small reason, this reason, so grid massively entity too large to affected by the relatively small size. The grid size is very large, and but the rating of the grid is very large. So, because of these reasons, this will large this microgrids is nothing but our distributed generators will affect the very more. So now see this some interconnections for this reason, because of this reason, these are some reasons. It's difficult time to understand why utilities some interconnecting and view utility requirements simply abstract design to events. What are some aspects? Some these are the some different aspects while interconnecting these. So, whenever we are interconnecting these diseases like this, these two cases, case one and case two, there is any economical benefit for interconnecting these two. So in this case, we are connected. So in the load locations, in this case, we are connected some far away from the load locations. What is the difference between these two? So what are the benefits of using these diseases? What are the, so some perspectives interconnecting these diseases? Why you are interconnecting these DGs near to the load locations? So even though the land cost and some cost is there nowadays, but even though we are using these DGs very much, so because the cost, the technology is improving. Okay, the cost of these DGs is reducing day by day. So then the technology to interconnect these DGs to the grid is increases. So that's why very much easily you can interconnect these diseases to the grid by using some net metering concept and all other things. So that's why the technology is increasing day by day. So the usage of these diseases also increasing. But remember, so while you are interconnecting these diseases, you are not treating these diseases as a base loads. As a base loads, we are not continuously running these diseases. So the base load is nothing but it is maintaining the continuous, it can give the continuous power to the loads. But these DGs will not give any continuous power to the loads. As certain limits are there, certain time is there. But suppose we are considering some solar plants in our college, the morning time the power generation is very more. But night time, so the sun is not available, the sunlight. So that's why the power generating is very less or nil also. But we are considering these some wind plants. The morning time the wind energy generation is less when compared to the night time. So night time the wind flowing is very high. So that's why this wind plants will generate the solar nothing but the wind energy at night time is very less, very very high. So there are some limitations are there while using this DGs in the power system. So these are the some perspectives, some interconnect. So now what are the some technologies while using the DGs? So it is not the technologies. Suppose these are some different types of the DGs. So diesel generator sets, reciprocating engine generation set is nothing but the diesel generation set. So gas turbine type of the generators. So like in our Simhachalam area, we are identifying this gas turbine plants. So the fuel cells is nothing but battery operated solar plants, some wind turbines, photovoltaic systems. Okay, so next class. So we are going to discuss this different technologies that we are going to use in the DGs. Okay, different technologies are different types of DGs we are going to use in the process. In the next class, we are going to discuss. Thank you. Thank you for joining us.